This evening, you can see it swirling right over my shoulder here, what's being called a superstorm tonight. Hurricane Sandy is more than 200 miles off the coast.
I can tell you now, it is impossible to go in that area at all. That area is now underwater.
From the air, destruction as far as the eye can see. Fires smoldering, some still burning even after the worst winds had passed. Entire lots of homes gone.
This is Seabright, New Jersey. This is an area called the Barrier Island. These range from Monmouth County down into Ocean County. It's a strip of land between the ocean and the bay and the incoming river. And during Superstorm Sandy, the ocean, and due to the high tides and wind, came across into this area. And just to give you some perspective, this high water mark here was as high as the water got. I'm standing on the curb, so you can imagine it's a little higher. But anything basically level with this line here was flooded out. And this on the other side here is the peninsula, and many, many houses here were destroyed during flooding. And if you weren't damaged by flooding, most of these area residents were without power for 2 to 3 weeks. The technology that was coming out at the time back in 2011, 2012 was GPSing of our assets, valves and hydrants, but also the shutoffs that go to the service lines for the various houses. There was a pilot that was done on the Barrier Islands down near the Bayhead area where we actually GPSed all the shutoffs. Typically, those measurements of where those shutoffs are taken from utility poles, corners of houses, and fences. You can imagine during Superstorm Sandy, that was all gone. Houses removed, gone, disappearing. So having those GPS coordinates and be able to find those shutoffs to turn off those waters to shut down any services that were leaking because they were severed from the houses. That illustrated the importance of such technology, and that GPSing has continued throughout our assets in New Jersey and other states. One of the things you can imagine after a storm like this is really just assessing the damage to our facilities. But the other thing that we did, we broke into teams, is really go to our hardest hit towns and really knock on those doors of those borough halls and administrations just to find out what they might need, an immediate need from us, as well as just making sure that they knew we were here, we were assessing the damage, and fire protection, of course, and making sure our assets were going to be repaired was top priority. So prioritization of that was key. A lot of municipalities appreciated the outreach and knew that we were there for them. So when a storm like this hits, the team comes together, and we had a lot of employees that were also impacted, yet they're showing up every day to work. And keep in mind, most of our employees don't have power at their houses, so they're lacking food. We had to try to make sure our employees had lunch, food available, so we try to get fruit, canned soup and those things, and had to go some far distance to get that. But the other thing too is just making sure everybody remains safe. People handle stress in different ways, so a lot of people were stressed out because they were having personal experiences at their house as well due to storm damage. And then some people are somewhat quiet too, and then talking to employees and finding out that a fellow employee may have been impacted severely by the storm. I remember one employee who lost everything they had. They had a condo and it was flooded out, and we came together as a team, and we went to their place and helped them deal with that stress of just going through their personal items and knowing certain things were going to have to get discarded. And just helping them deal with that loss and showing them that we were there for them. So I've been with this organization for about 33 years, and many events during my career, but Superstorm Sandy was probably the most significant event that we had to deal with. And it really highlighted the value of the resiliency projects that we had done to date, but also highlighted the need to do more resiliency projects to help protect our important infrastructure.